al-Hadith are considered and they're described as being a ta'ifa. And a ta'ifa, he was making a point here that a ta'ifa is a group. A group doesn't necessarily mean a jama'ah. A jama'ah, that type of group. So it doesn't mean that. Ta'ifa here doesn't also mean a lot of people. A lot of people. It doesn't mean that. He said it's possible that a ta'ifa can have a lot of people, but this hadith that's talking about this group of people, it's not necessarily what comes to your mind is a lot of people. He said that's not the case. He said that this word ta'ifa, there will not cease to be a group of people. This Arabic word ta'ifa, it is something that can imply only one person. It can imply only one person. It doesn't have to be a lot of people. It doesn't have to be a group of people. He said, and we understand that from the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, when he gave the definition of the true jama'ah in al-Islam. He said that the jama'ah is what is consistent with the truth, even if you are by yourself. So the jama'ah is what is inconsistent, what's being consistent with the haqq. Although you may be by yourself. He went on to say, so when we come to the issue of al-Hadith, we don't ask about how many people. That's not the issue. The question is, where is the haqq? That's the question. The question is, how do you make the tabligh of this dawah? The question is, where is the guidance? The question is where is the concern that the people are given to this guidance? And that comes from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that shows all of that. None of you truly believes until you love for your brother what you love for yourself from what is good.